but for protocol's sake, I shall introduce him. He's the president and founder of Dynamite Word Ministry. He's married with two boys. And he's currently doing Masters in Business Administration with the Management College of South Africa. He's a qualified optometrist and he's still practicing. Ladies and gentlemen, he's an apostle of God. I know what I'm talking about. The man of God came here in 2010. In 2011, I was here. And I know what happened to my life. I don't know about you, but some of you think you're ready, but I'm not sure if you're really ready for this man of God. Like, I know what I'm talking about. So, as we give a great shout of praise unto God, the man of God, Apostle T.E. Mopai, will be joining me in this stage.
That could not hold you down. I greet you in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
I never felt an anointing in one building like what I experienced when I entered here. I want to acknowledge the leadership of the SCF under the leadership of Amazement and his wonderful team for granting me this opportunity to come and share the mysteries of this life that we have with you. Amen. Thank you so much, man of God. I greatly desire to come to Cape Town for a long time. And thank you that God used you to make that vision come to pass. Greatly, we are going to be blessed tonight.
Amen.
You will never forget and regret this day. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I usually tell people that there is a process that is called genetic engineering. And it's going to happen while you are seated right there.
Amen.
Amen. We thank God for this time. I don't need to introduce myself, they've already introduced me. I know I look more short than what they say about me. But great I see that is in me.
Amen.
Hallelujah. If you use the right x-ray, you'll be able to see my right size. You can understand who I am. Wow. I feel sorry for those who are not here. Really. It's going to be glorious. My wife wanted to come with me, but certain things happened and she had to remain. She was actually crying tears when I left her because she wanted to be here. I won't tell her what happened here because I'll cry more. Amen.
Amen.
Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay. One thing that he forgot to tell you is that as we're speaking in the car, that 2 weeks ago, they brought a lady that died into the church, which was a violation of our church policies. And then, and I couldn't take that. So we actually called her where she was, and then she came back into the building. And last week she was giving us the testimony of different dimensions in the spiritual where she was. And realize that there's more that we can do as the sons of God.
Amen.
Amen. You know, I came here with a word for you.
Amen.
Are you sure you will take it?
Yes.
Do you have the capacity?
Yes.
To lambano it?
Yes.
Many of you, tremendous things will happen to you tonight. You will know that you were in the presence of the living God. Amen.
Amen.
Certain things will happen inside you. You know the things that the life which we have will need days and days and days of talking and presentation. But through the Spirit of God, we will try within the time limit that we have to communicate these things unto you. And I know I've prayed for you that God will give you understanding. So you will understand. You will receive it. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Father, I thank you tonight. I always wondered what happens when a man is born again. And it's amazing that there's a lot of superficiality when it comes to that thing. Please allow me to communicate to you softly because I'm trying to control something inside me. When the vavavoom comes, I'm a man of vavavoom. So I'm trying to keep it away for now. I always wondered what, please listen to me very carefully. I always wondered what happens when a man is born again, and what actually is Christianity in simple terms, and what makes us different from those that are not born again. And what I found out is amazing, and actually it can revolutionize your personal life. There are certain things that happens when a man is born again. And the university, it is the perfect place to communicate those things. Because it's an institution that designed exclusively for communication of knowledge. And you know, students are strategically placed by God to impact this generation. Because here, we have the liberty to investigate every knowledge. Amen. But I brought another school or faculty or department, which is not here in the university. And thank God he has placed us in this hall tonight so that we can bless the entire university. Yes. Hallelujah. Yes. You know, we as Christians usually neglect the very foundations of our faith and what makes us unique and different from the rest of the world. And should we really understand and zoom on those things? You know, God has given me tremendous revelations about the human body, the impact of salvation on the human body. And this is because after being born again, we are still allowed to live on the earth. And you know, the current dispensation, we live in the physical body. And so God put us here so that we can display certain virtues that he has worked inside us. Amen. Amen. Now, what really complicates, as I hear comments and opinions from Christians, what complicates the simplicity of being born again is usually from the lack of understanding that there are three races as far as God is concerned. God said in his word that I shook the earth and I'm going to shake it again. But he said this time I will not shake the earth only, but I will shake also the heavens. So faith, according to me, is actually shaking the heavens with God. The realm of spiritual entities while you are living in the physical body. As far as God is concerned, there are three races. And it's very important because that is the foundation of salvation. And the way God deals with them is not the same. You know, we have the Jews that are the biological seed of Abraham. And then we have the Gentiles, anybody that is not a Jew. And then we have the Christian. And there are certain verses that are only talking to the Jews. And there are certain verses that are only talking to the Gentiles. There are certain verses that are talking to the Christian. Sometimes when you don't understand these three classifications of races, you can misappropriate verses and overthrow your faith. There's a scripture in Deuteronomy 22 verse 5 that says, a man must not wear the clothes of a woman, and a woman must not wear the clothes of a man. But that is what actually Moses talking to the Jews. That scripture is not for the Gentiles. That scripture is not for the Christian. And but some people use that scripture to say women must not wear trousers. Maybe you want to wear that jean, go on and wear it. Because for a Christian, it does not really matter whether you are wearing a trouser or not. Because it does not even define who you are. He said the beauty of the woman is not in the outward appearance. It's not in the wearing of a jean or not, but in the inner man of the heart. So we should not really waste our energy on things that are not relevant to this life. So there are scriptures that are talking to the Jews. Can you say amen?
Amen.
And there's also a gospel that is designed for the Jews. You remember even when Jesus
before he died. He told his disciples that don't go to the Gentiles. Because the curriculum of the gospel he gave them could not reach the Gentiles. It was only for the Jews. He said, only go to the lost sheep of Israel. And then one day he found a man called Apostle Paul. The first. Was actually, we have the second now. Can you say amen? Now, so this man, even Paul himself said, the same God that energized Peter to the Jews is the same God that energized me, Paul, to the Gentiles. Now, I would say joke with people and ask them, which Jesus are you serving? Because there's Jesus the Jew. Then there's Jesus the Son of God. And Jesus the Jew was not as powerful as Jesus the Son of God. Because he had certain powers. But when the Jew died, and God gave birth to his son from the dead. He said, all power has been given unto me. And actually, Christianity is born there. Do you understand? Now, many people don't know this one, the Son of God. They know the Son of Mary. It is that transition that after the last apostles, information was lost. And the church today did not have that impartation. But we will do it tonight in the mighty name of Jesus. All right, let us go back. There's a gospel for the Jews. There's a gospel for the Gentiles. Then there's a gospel for the Christian. All right? For example, when you read in Galatians 3, verse 13 there. I say Cape Town will never be the same. Because this is one of the verses that really speaks about the program of God to these three races. Have you ever imagined as a Christian why you ask God for something and you don't have it? Why you are a Christian, then you are sick. Why you are a Christian, then you struggle from certain things. And it's as if God doesn't love you or doesn't answer your prayer. No, the problem is we don't understand who we are and how God deals with us. But that will be sorted out. Now, for example, you see, when you start from verse 12, it tells you that the law is not of faith. The law is not of faith. We know that the law came by Moses to the Jews, not to the Gentiles, not to the Christian. The law came by Moses to the Jews. Now, it's telling you the law is not of faith. Because we know we are saved by faith. Hallelujah. We are of faith. But the law is not of faith. And the law is for the Jews. Now, I will tell you the significance different. But verse 13, let's read verse 13. Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law. Who is us? Tell me, talk to me. Who is us then? No, Christians never had a law to be redeemed from. Huh? The Jews. Paul was a Jew. That's why he said us. No matter how you shout it, even if you have a volcano voice, and you say, Christ has redeemed us, you are not, you are lying. It will not work. Listen, it's important to accurately understand the gospel because the Spirit of God has come for the gospel. To glorify Jesus Christ. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. So us there is for the Jews. Because it says Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law. It is the Jews that were given the law. It was given to them because sin had increased after a certain promise that God gave them. Now that law had blessings and curses. So the curses were not for the Gentiles, it was for the Jews. So Paul is saying to the Jews, Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law. Being made a curse for us, for it is written, cursed is everyone that hangeth on a tree. Verse 14. That the blessing of Abraham might come on the Gentiles through faith. Because the law could not give God's blessing to the Gentiles. So he redeemed them from the curse of the law, so that the blessings of Abraham might come on the Gentiles through faith. That we, who are we? Can I see those who are saying Christians? Raise up your hands. Alright, those who are saying Jews. Those who don't care. You will see the anointing that will move in this house by the time we start praying. Now that anointing is generated by the kind of understanding you are receiving now. Something is happening inside you. Now it says, Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law. Then verse 14, that the blessing of Abraham might come on the Gentiles through Christ Jesus, that we, who are we? Both Jews and Gentiles who believe in Christ. We, that both we might receive what? The promise of the Spirit through faith. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Can you say amen?
Amen?
So God had a program for both the Jews and the Gentiles that through Jesus Christ they might receive the promise of the Spirit. So the goal was for them to receive the promise of the Spirit. Can you say amen?
Amen.
So you need to understand that this program of bringing the Jews and bringing the Gentiles, it's very, very powerful. And you need to understand it accurately. Because that is when the true love of God will be generated from you. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Can you say amen?
Amen.
Listen up. There's a scripture that the man of God sent to me. I think you put it on the poster. That you are bought with a price. Be ye not the servants of men. Ye are bought with a price. Be ye not the servants of men. Now, let's go to another one. I'm trying the best I can. Let's start with Romans chapter 1, verse 3. Do you love the word of God?
Yes.
Are you sure? I want to tell you what happens when a man is born again. But I wanted to start with this introductory thing so that we can have a nice background. Now, he's talking, let's start from verse 2. Which he had promised, can somebody read it for us, please? If you are there, you got it. Romans chapter 1, read verse 2.
Which he had promised before by his prophet in the Holy Scriptures.
He's talking about the gospel. This gospel, God promised by his holy prophet. They didn't preach it. They were just told he's coming. Are you listening to me? The prophets themselves didn't preach it. But they prophesied that he's coming. Okay, let's continue.
Let's pray. Concerning his son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, which was made of the seed of David according to the flesh.
Ha! Which was made of the seed. Now begin to listen. Which was made of the seed of David according to the flesh. The Greek word for seed is sperm. It's sperm. Can you say sperm?
Sperm.
Listen very carefully. careful. You understand this, you will no longer struggle in your life again. Hallelujah. The Bible shows us that Jesus came from the seed of David according to the flesh. Jesus was of the seed of David. I always tell people that, do you know that a human being comes from the male sperm? The body of a human being is there. Remember, there is no blood in the sperm. But when that thing, that seed, listen, a man, when I'm alone, I'm carrying millions and millions of them. But because of mortality, I might not be able to produce all of them. So I must hand them to my son. Then my son will hand them to his son. Now, when I drop it in the womb of the woman, what happens? The woman does not even give the child the body. If the woman was giving the child the body, Jesus was born sinful. Because Mary was sinful. The sperm carries the human soul. When it's dropped in the womb, the sperm produces its own bones. It produces its own blood. We know that the blood of the child doesn't come from the mother or the father. It produces its own. If they mix, they both die. So Jesus was of the seed of David according to the flesh.
Oh my God.
Then when he was born the Son of Man. Jesus operated as the Son of Man. He never operated as the Son of God. He operated as the Son of God after he was raised from the dead. That's why when he went to a mountain to be tested, Satan brought to him and said, "Worship me and I will give you the kingdoms of the world. Because they were given unto me and I can give them to anybody that I like." Jesus never said, "You are lying." He said, "I will only worship the Father." But by that time, Satan had more power than Jesus to control the Gentiles. That power, it's Adam who gave it to Satan. Satan was using the Adamic power, but he didn't know that Jesus was the second and the last Adam. And then he was coming to actually take it. The Bible says he came through flesh and blood, so that through death he might defeat him that had the power of death. That is the devil. So by that time, Satan had power to determine the gender of a child in the stomach. Because this authority was given to Adam. When God made Adam, he said to him, "Multiply, be fruitful." Satan had power to make sure that a child can be born crippled. A lot of problems that people are suffering today happened while they were in the womb, while they were being designed in the mother's womb. But we are going to cancel everything today by the power of the Holy Ghost. Now the Bible shows that Jesus was of the seed of David. Now when you read the next verse, it says, "And declared to be the Son of God with power by the resurrection from the dead." So Jesus was born the Son of David for the first time. Then he was born again the Son of God. All right. Listen to me. How many here have, even if he passed away, but you have a biological father, raise up your hand. Oh, maybe because you are me. Let me say, the one who doesn't have. Not because you lost him or you don't know him, but you came to the earth, you don't have a biological father. Raise up your hand, please. Oh, we don't have anybody. Do you allow me to communicate these things? Listen. A man is born first according to the flesh. Then born again according to the spirit. Your problem is not because you don't pray. Your problem is how were you born? Your father. Listen, if your father, for example, was cursed, let me give that example. You don't have to commit a sin to be cursed because you were born by him. So for you to be delivered from that thing, you need to be born again. What happens when a man is born again? Because that is really the issue. What happens when a man is born again? I said a man is born for the first time according to the flesh. Then he's born again according to the spirit. Hallelujah!
Amen.
How many of you are born again? Thank you. It means, okay, what is to be born again? What is again? It means for the second time. So it means you were born for the first time. Then you are born again. Now, do you realize there were changes? Between your first born and your again born. Do you realize there were changes? Do you realize there lies the secret of the gospel of Jesus Christ? Do you realize there lies the power of eternal life? When you are born again, you don't have to deal with sin. When you are born again, you don't have to deal with generational curses because you don't have them. Can you shout amen?
Amen!
When you are born again. Oh my God. Actually, when I entered here, the Lord told me something. And I said, Lord, are you sure? He said, who do you think I am? And I checked it by the scripture. Oh. And I'm going to share it with you. This will, do you know the scripture that says, those who live in the flesh cannot please God. The flesh is enmity with God. The flesh and the spirit are fighting. And there are many Christians who are trying to subdue the flesh. There are many Christians who are still trying to do massive prayers against the flesh. And God told me, there's a difference between the flesh and the body. There's a difference between the flesh and the body. Can I preach this thing? The flesh. Oh. The flesh is the life that energizes a natural man who is born in this world. The flesh is the biological life that comes from one's biological father. The hormonal system, the vascular system, the nervous system that controls your emotions. That is the flesh. That is where the seat of sin dwelt. That is where Satan's nature dwelt. So a man of the flesh, no matter how he prays, no matter how he fasts, he cannot be holy. He cannot live a holy life. Because the problem is the kind of life he possesses. The flesh works in the body. They are not the two. They are not the same. That's why he said Jesus was of the seed of David according to the flesh. The life life which he lived was that of David, the generation of David, from Abraham. Now God told me when I was here, he said, a Christian doesn't have the flesh. A Christian doesn't have it. Because when you read in Galatians chapter 5 from verse 24 there, it says those who belong to Christ have crucified. The flesh, oh, the flesh is the remote control of Satan in the human body. Those who belong to Christ have crucified. Can you say crucified?
Crucified.
I want to hear the D.
Crucified.
Is it going to happen?
No.
Is it happening now?
No.
It has happened. He has crucified. Which means, all right, let me get one. Brother, what is your name? Chikobi. Yes, is that your father saying? It means, according to the flesh, he's a Chikobi. Listen. It means the generational cases of the Chikobi works through the sending, works through the bloodline. But the moment he was born again, he was disconnected from the Chikobi and he became a new species. When we say a man is born again, what happens? The flesh is crucified, not the body. Hallelujah! This is the secret of power. When you are born again, you are not of this world. When you are born again, you are not a human being. That's why he says, do not be a servant of human beings. For example, oh my God, when you're not born again, the flesh loves the world. The flesh loves the things of the air. There are three kinds of love. There's agape, the love of God. There is filio, brotherly love. Then there's eros, the love of husband and wife. But let me tell you about filio, because this one is very important for young people. Filio is when you look at a sister and say, oh, share it. This is where the problems of the world is. Filio is when you are moved with an emotion. Filio is when you see somebody that you love and say, my. Jesus Christ. Yes. Once you take that filio, you give it to a human being. The Bible says you are functioning under a curse. That filio, that vavavum, must be given to Jesus Christ. Yes. Then you will not have a stress. Yes. Then you will be truly happy. Yes. If you give it to property, if you give it to a human being, you will be frustrated. Yeah. Because that thing is the driving force of a human life on the earth. Ask your neighbor, who do you feel? Are going to be restored. wish I had the whole night with you. So we can talk about these things.
Yeah.
There are many people who are hurt.
Misleading many because they magnify the filial to the world.
Yeah.
But brother, when you love Jesus, he will fix that person that you want. Yeah. You must first understand a Christian does not have a flesh.
Yeah.
We read it in Galatians, he said, those who belong to Jesus have done what? Crucified. Then in Romans 8, 9, he said, from 5, he says, those who walk in the flesh cannot please God. To be carnally minded is an enmity with God. And then he goes on. Then when he comes around, he says, ye are not of the flesh.
Yeah.
Is there? He says, ye are not in the flesh, but in the spirit. When you are born again, you are no longer energized by the flesh. You are no longer vitalized by the blood. You are vitalized by the spirit. That's what makes you different from the person who's not born again. That's why you don't have any habits that you need to break. Because you have new habits. New love for God. New life of righteousness. New holiness. New dreams. Sickness cannot prevail in your body. You don't struggle with sickness. The Bible says this is the mystery that was hidden from the previous generations. Now it's revealed. Christ in you. It says this Christ is the fullness of God, somaticus, which means bodily. Understand how God dealt with the flesh. So the church doesn't have to deal with the flesh. The church doesn't have the flesh. The church has Zoe. We are new species. Understand? We have the same body. But inside, if the spirit of him that raised Jesus from the dead lives in you, he will vitalize your mortal body, not your flesh. In Romans 8, 13, it says, if ye live by the flesh, ye shall die.
Yeah.
But it says, if ye through the spirit mortify the deeds of the body, it's not even saying the flesh. It says, if you kill the transactions of the body, because some of us are filled with the Holy Ghost, but some are filled with the flesh ghost. What do I mean by that? It means the ghost of your flesh is still convincing you that you are not done with that brother. You are not done with that sister. The ghost of your flesh still convinces you, maybe before you got born again you were a drunkard. It's still convincing you that the desire of alcohol is still there. It's a ghost. Kill it.
Amen.
Can you shout amen?
Amen.
Shout amen.
Amen.
Tell him it's a ghost.
It's a ghost.
That's why I think I always tell people that when a sister is born again, even if she has got 4 children before marriage, but she's born again, she's now a virgin. She's no longer having any ex on her. If they meet her and say, this one is my ex, you tell them, no, your ex is a ghost. It's going to be. UCT in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We are going to change Cape Town in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Look at Colossians 3.
Yeah.
I think the Vavavum is starting.
Yeah.
Ah! Let's start from verse 1. Ah, my God, my God. Shout Vavavum. Do you know what is Vavavum? Vavavum is filial.
Ha ha ha!
body and the blood goes. And the heart goes. We need to talk about these things. Ask them again, who do you feel you? Verse 1. Listen. Oh, is there? Thank you. Who's putting it there? God bless you. I didn't see it. Okay. If ye then be risen with Christ, seek those things which are where?
Above.
Seek those things which are in upper campus. Seek those things which are in the leadership of SCF.
No.
Seek those things. Seek those things which are
above.
Where?
Above.
Where Christ seated on the right hand of God. To seek means earnestly desire. Woo. Pursue. Woo. With your heart.
Yeah.
Let's go on. You haven't seen anything yet. Set your affection. Do you have the Strong's Concordance there? Do you have the King James with the Strong, those?
Yeah.
Is there inside there? Is that Esau? Is that Esau? Okay. Can you check for me the Greek word for affection? Alright, first let's analyze. It says set your affection on things. Not on things where?
On
where's the boyfriend? Born again. Alright? Set your affection. What is the Greek word for affection?
Pruneo.
What? Pruneo. How do you what does it mean?
Affection. It means have sentiment or opinion. It means to be of one's party. It also means to be of the same mind.
Mm-hmm.
It also means to think. To judge one's opinion, it also means to have understanding, to be wise.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now, that one is a small one. I say it means vavavu. It means affection, which is at the center of the heart of every young person. Affection. He says, set your affection on things above. When the Bible talks about the husband and the wife, there's no way the Bible says, filio, your wife. Or filio, your husband. It says, agape your wife. Agape your husband. Give the baba food to Jesus. Can you shout amen? Can you shout amen? And the Bible shows us that that's why a lot of women in history, I know not in Cape Town, in the history of the church, many demons are in women. Not in Cape Town, of course. Why? The Bible says because they are ever learning. They are filled with many filial. Ever learning but never come to the understanding of the truth. They love to put their filial on earth. So they have many worries. But when you are born again, you receive eternal life. Because why is this one related with... can you bring it back, please? It says, set your affection on the things... above, not on the things on the earth. Tell your neighbor, set your filio above.
Set your filio above.
Not on the earth. Hallelujah.
Amen.
This filio is where, I think one time I spoke about a message ministering the spirit. Some people have got that thing. How you release power. Power, spiritual power. How you ooze power. You ooze it through affection. So if you put your affection on earthly things, your power will be choked. Your faith will be weak. Your prayer life will be weak. You cannot make impact. You will be full of zoe, but it won't show. You will be a Christian, but live the same life like people are not born again. Struggle with the same things like people are not born again. Even argue against the spirit of the living God. You will struggle with the simple things about faith. Because your affection is on the wrong things. For your faith to work well, put your affection on above. I don't hear your amen.
Amen.
We're going to pray tonight.
Amen.
I said we're going to pray tonight.
Amen.
Why does he say you must set your affection on things above? Let's go to the next one. At two verses, then we are done. For you are?
Yes.
It's talking about the flesh. You are dead. Then your life is hid with Christ in God. Now what if the flesh goes, comes back? What? Kill it! No, you don't have to tell it to go back. You kill it. If you tell it to go back, it will say no. Read verse 5. Give us verse 5. Mortify. The word mortify means kill. Therefore, your members which are upon the earth. Then it begins to list those kind of things. In Romans 8:13, it's talking about the same thing. It says, by the Spirit, through the Spirit, mortify the deeds of the body. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Can I have the keyboardist? Thank you, sir. I want you to give me a string. Get ready, get ready, get ready, get ready. Music. It's a tool that communicates easily with the affections of men. That's why we worship through music before we minister the word. Are you born again? Are you born again?
Yes.
You are not of this world. You don't have to fight with anybody, with the devil. You are not even his type. You are not in his class. You don't have to fight with sickness. There are many unhappy people in the world. Many people have got questions against God. But God loves us so much. God loves you so much. And he wants to direct your affection in the right place. Because there's nobody like you. There will never be anybody like you. You are unique and you are relevant for this generation.
Amen.
Allow the Holy Ghost to unveil that peculiarity. I have grace to make you become what I preach. As I'm going to minister to you tonight, many of you, your first love for God will be rekindled. You will win souls like never before. And anything that has been standing on your way, you will get it out of the way. I'm just asking the Lord, what can I do with this power now? Brothers and sisters, we have power. We have tremendous power. We have tremendous power. Kira do seleva inji alkesu. You don't have to struggle inside anymore. The struggle is over. The fear is over. The doubt is gone. Speak in tongues. If you don't know how to speak in tongues, just pray. Pray in the language that you are comfortable with. Liga kobrashta. Liga kalushta. Kaya basuta Jilabos katile mundo roskila hasali prade ne kadesh. Jaluka sobra hadi demonstra de la coche. Jesus. Liga bo usala hatel bo zeriga. Jalibo usarabante libo riska la hata libanes. Liba som talamande le bo shila haskarido. The fellowship of the Spirit. Shata karibo selinanze libaskudele askobendalisha. Libo satus kariba labaya saliga samandorusha. Shilabo salahata libusha. Libo satabradila kosalamasha. Speak, speak unto the Spirit. Speak with the Spirit right now. Speak with him right now. Speak with him right now. Speak with him right now. A fresh wave of anointing is falling upon your faculties. It's falling upon your body. Shatoski bala kedi sore atiarusi. Lizo brusele adi kasele. Ratilo usala makatesi la mai. Shila busata kadi brusele ata. Si la bolsa di bande di bisca la scadina, riproscia lì la bande di disco bradina passata lì. Libra se le bande di tosci la pareta, libra di la brasina calato brusi la bandesca, libra di la brina le fondo ruschi la bata, gli abruzze di la bruschi la bande di bossa la bata. Libra sciondo rossi a brighe delle vasche di bata. Thank you.